Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss one of the new medication, Benralizumab. Benralizumab is well known by its brand name, FASENRA. This drug is one of the monoclonal antibody. Here we can identify the suffix mab, which indicates it is a monoclonal antibody. And we can see the suffix jumab, where ZU indicates that it is a humanized monoclonal antibody. So Benralizumab is a humanized monoclonal antibody that is available as either prefilled pen or syringe, and it is indicated in the treatment of eosinophilic asthma. So in the severe condition of eosinophilic asthma, we can observe excessive activation of eosinophils. These eosinophils can be infiltrated into the lungs, where they can induce inflammation. This inflammatory response initially develops asthmatic symptoms, but on chronic conditions, it can increase the recurrent attacks of asthma. So in such patients, we can observe shortness of breath, excessive wheezing and coughing, and the severity of attacks are further increased with enhanced levels of eosinophils. In such conditions, Benralizumab can be given as an antibody to counteract the effects of raised eosinophils. This medication is popular under the brand name FASENRA and is available as single dose prefilled syringe or auto injector pen. So here we can see an auto injector pen in the diagram, and it can be given by subcutaneous injection. Administration of this medication should be careful. The injection should be stored into the refrigerator, and before the administration, they should be taken out of the refrigerator and they should be kept at the room temperature for at least 30 minutes. So during this 30 minutes, the liquid in the pen is get warm and it comes to the room temperature. And before administration, we have to check the prefilled syringe or pen for any defects. So we have to confirm that the liquid is clear to opalescent and it is either colorless to slightly yellow color, but this liquid is not cloudy and it is not having any large particles. If it is cloudy or if you observe any large particles, immediately it should not be administered and should be discarded. Before administration, the site of injection should be cleaned with an alcohol wipe, and the site of injection may be variable. It can be given at abdomen, thigh or upper arm. And the site of injection can be rotated with each time of its use. And if auto injector pen is used, the injection can be completed within the two click sounds that can be produced by the pen. So in the people with eosinophilic asthma, this medication proved very useful. So today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug acts. Eosinophils may be expressed with one type of receptors, IL-5 receptors. These are the interleukin-5 receptors on which interleukin-5 can act. Once this IL-5 is released and it can bind to this IL-5 receptors, it can stimulate the eosinophil activation. So eosinophils are more produced and more released, and they can be infiltrated into the lungs so that they can produce some inflammatory response. Because of this infiltration, they can release few of the mediators. These mediators can cause a second phase of inflammation. Few of the mediators like eosinophilic cationic protein, ECP, major basic protein, MBP, these are the anions or cations which can produce some damage to the respiratory muscle. Thereby, they can produce symptoms of asthma, resulting in severe wheezing and coughing. So in such conditions, Benralizumab can be given, which is a humanized monoclonal antibody. This drug can target the IL-5 receptors located on eosinophil. It can bind to a particular domain IL-5 receptor alpha chain with high affinity, so that now IL-5 cannot bind to these eosinophils and it cannot promote the eosinophil proliferation. In this way, the number of eosinophil activated can be controlled by Benralizumab. Apart from this action, this Benralizumab can bind to another target, natural killer cells, NK cells. At the Benralizumab, one of the binding sites is Fc gamma or 3 alpha. This binding site is having the high affinity towards the NK cells so that they can be bound to this Benralizumab. Once they bound, they can release few of the mediators. These mediators can cause apoptosis of eosinophils so that their activity is going to be inhibited. In this way, benralizumab can reduce the eosinophil activation as well as it can increase the apoptosis of eosinophils, thereby can reduce the number of eosinophils in the body. This reduces the inflammation produced by eosinophils, that's why it can be used in the treatment of eosinophilic asthma. Now let us the precautions of benralizumab. This drug should not be given to treat acute bronchospasm because it is not working immediately and it is not suitable for acute conditions. Similarly, it cannot be given to treat status asthmaticus, which is a severe asthmatic condition with uncontrolled bronchospasm. Again, in such conditions, benralizumab should not be given because this drug is not a bronchodilator. Instead, it acts as an antibody to reduce eosinophil activation and proliferation. So this drug is only indicated in eosinophilic asthma, but in the acute conditions of asthma, benralizumab is not useful. Similarly, those people who are taking corticosteroids, the dose of corticosteroids should not be stopped suddenly. This benralizumab is not equivalent, so corticosteroids should not be suddenly stopped. And if it is required, they can be withdrawn slowly by reducing the dose over a long period. If these corticosteroids are suddenly stopped, they can produce various withdrawal symptoms like bronchospasm, unexpected weakness, mood changes, dizziness, and increased anxiety. Many of these conditions can be produced by sudden withdrawal of corticosteroids. These symptoms are collectively called as withdrawal symptoms. So when you start benralizumab, the corticosteroid therapy should not be stopped immediately, and the dose of corticosteroid should be slowly reduced in order to avoid any withdrawal symptoms. Similarly, benralizumab should not be given in the people with any helminth infections because, as we have seen, benralizumab can reduce the eosinophils. These eosinophils play an important role in fighting with helminth infections. So when these eosinophils are inhibited, the risk of helminth infection can be increased. That's why benralizumab should not be given in the people with pre-existing helminth infections. Before administration, any helminth infection should be treated, and when it is completely cleared, benralizumab therapy should be started. Another important precaution is that this drug can produce some hypersensitive reactions resulting in angioedema. It can produce some swelling of face, neck, tongue, and lips. So in such conditions, like any facial swelling or ankle swelling, or development of any anaphylaxis resulting in skin rashes, redness of the skin, if these symptoms are observed, immediately benralizumab should be stopped as it may lead to fatal hypersensitive reactions. So in those people who are allergic to benralizumab, this drug should not be used. Now let us the side effects. This drug is well tolerated and it can produce few of the side effects like headache, pharyngitis, and it can also produce some raise in the body temperature. Apart from these, it can produce few of the local side effects like hypersensitivity, pain at site of injection, and erythema, redness at the site of injection. How it is given? This drug is available as either pre-filled pen or syringe, and it is suitable for subcutaneous injection. It is available at a dose of 30 mg as a single dose. So initial 3 doses of this drug can be given at a dose of 30 mg given every 4 weeks. So for every 4 weeks, one subcutaneous injection is given, which is a single dose of 30 mg. After 4 weeks of the treatment, the dose can be given as 30 mg for every 8 weeks. So now the dosing interval is somewhat increased after 4 weeks of the treatment. And this drug is suitable only in the adults and children, but children less than 12 years, this drug is not suitable. So that's all about this medication, benralizumab, which is a IL-5 receptor antagonist. It is a humanized monoclonal antibody. This drug can be used for the treatment of eosinophilic asthma, where it can reduce the eosinophil activation and proliferation. It also increases the apoptosis of eosinophils, thereby it can reduce the risk of eosinophilic asthma. So that's all about this medication, benralizumab. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.